No retro, no indifferent designs, and no bland colorways today. Russell Westbrook is probably the wildest competitor out there, and the Why Not Zer0.2 is definitely reflective of his personality. Powerful, colorful, unique, and a great performer. Ladies and gents, I am Steph from 99 Sneakers, and today we are going to review the second signature shoe by Russell Westbrook. The story goes like this. The first Why Not sneaker was not intended to be Russ's signature shoe, but that changed in the last minute. With that being said, the first shoe, which was a great looking sneaker by the way, was marketed as his shoe, but actually, he probably had nothing to do with it creatively. The funny thing was that I bought them when they came out and tried to wear them, but like many unfortunate owners, I realized that the shoes were really tough at my ankles and I was barely able to move, let alone break them in. I guess that's the reason you can find them today at a big discount in various outlet stores. Next thing I knew, the shoes were returned and I forgot all about his signature line until this came up. And then this, and this, and the list goes on. Come on, Russ, show us some mercy over here. If this sneaker has your input and your design approval, then you have my kudos. My friends, the Why Not Zer0.2 are not only truly unique, they seem to also perform well. How would I know? I just bought them too, in the original amazing colorway. Now, let's dive into the details. Playing into these basketball shoes was not an extraordinary experience, but it was good from the first moment I laced them up. Traction was really cool since the shoes gripped straight away. The circular patterns were working just fine in indoor courts. Since my basketball shoes rotation is quite big, I don't know if I expect a long-lasting outsole, but performance-wise, these are certainly great. The underfoot feeling of the Phylon is not bad at all. With this model, we're getting impact protection with a large volume zoom air unit that we did in the Air Jordan 32 and 33, but without the breaking time. The Zer0.2 is a little bouncier also, so that was something I really enjoyed. The upper boasts mesh and knit and the combination works. The shoe fits true to size. I am wearing 10.5 and it fits me greatly. Only if I lace up tightly, I feel that my blood flow is cut somehow. No suffocating lockdown feeling like at the first model, but you have to lace up carefully, at least that's what I felt. Since it's not yet hot, and I normally don't sweat at all, I can't tell much about moisture. On the other hand, the support is great, and at no point would I feel that my ankles are in danger in any situation. In general, I would give a positive verdict for the particular shoe. They are fast, comfortable and supportive, while at the same time they are not too pricey, at €129 in Europe and the same amount of dollars in the US. They are not a bargain, but for sure they feel like they are worth every cent. What is the real problem over here is the number of great colorways that Jordan brand has to offer. And if, I say if, somebody has the crazy idea to release Westbrook's crazy PEs, then the thing is going to become really wild. So what do you think of them? Would you buy them? If you already own a pair, do you rock them casually? Leave a comment below, and if you like the video, show us your love as well. Hit that subscribe button, magic will happen. Thank you.